Wombat Mater. This four-month-old baby follows his keeper, Shaun, everywhere. They're an inseparable team. Mater will take his first trip to the new nursery shortly. Will he find his independence on his journeys through the wildlife park? It's barely dawn at the Mount Field National Park. Wombat baby Mater is already chipper and enjoying his daily shower with his adoptive father, Shaun. When he loses interest, he simply leaves the wombat washer and patiently waits for the drying cycle. Mater really enjoys the drying off process. After a good rub down with a soft towel, he's ready to explore the wildlife park that Shaun works in. The animal park, something wild in Tasmania, south of Australia. Many other animals also call the park their home. Kangaroos, Tasmanian devils, koala bears, and many different varieties of birds. And of course, wombat.
They're very affectionate babies. They just, in the wild, they're never far from mum. They're never more than like 4 inches away from mum. They're just basically always right next to her. It's the same when you're hand raised.
Wildlife carers are females, but there are male wildlife carers around. They're just, yeah, seems to be more women, but I've always liked animals and that. And, you know, before I moved to Tasmania, which was over 3 years ago, I never thought I'd be raising a wombat. So, yeah. And other numerous native animals, so it's, yeah, basically a dream come true for me.
Stage one, wombat lives with me. Never too far, always on my side, comes home with me at night. Stage two, we introduce it into the nursery, starts to spend its day in the nursery by itself and with some of the other young animals that we're raising.
We're just going to weigh him, see how he's been gaining. We do this with all our young animals as they're growing up. Weighing's a real good sign of how they're going. You know, if they start losing weight, you know there's a problem. They shouldn't be losing weight. They should be staying the same, and of course, increasing weight.
It's now high time to see if Mater can find new friends among his own kind at the zoo.
To calm a wombat down. Works very well on the young wombats, but sometimes you can still do it on the older wombats, like Benny here. You just gently blow them on the nose, and it'll send them to sleep sometimes.
A born and bred wombat foster father like Shaun has all sorts of tricks up his sleeve in order to keep his wombats happy and asleep.